Hello everyone, I'm Tasneem Lightwala. This is Mayank Gupta, Harsh and Rohit. So our project is IP-based hardware infrastructure management for the cloud. So the main objective of our project is to monitor the servers on the hardware level. I mean, we have used Nagios for the monitoring purpose. Nagios is an open source network and server monitoring system. It easily accesses the public services like HTTP, SNMP, etc. And it also monitors the server resources like CPU, memory. It gives you notifications whenever a problem occurs in the system, and also alerts you when the problem is solved. So there are various ways you can be notified, like by email notifications, SMS notifications. So the objective was to monitor different servers and get the information like temperature sensor, voltage, fan speed, etc. But Nagios does not do that. So for that, we had to implement IPMI.
Good afternoon. So IPMI is a set of interfaces specification which helps us to monitor servers on the hardware level. So generally, when we monitor any specific computer or system, we need a particular application which runs on the operating system. But IPMI helps us to monitor those servers without any OS or without going through BIOS or anything. IPMI let us directly interact with the hardware of that particular system.
What I don't understand is, so with your system, so even if I switch off the machine, you will monitor it?
Yeah, we can monitor.
It's already zero, CPU is zero.
Yeah,
so what are you monitoring?
We can monitor the temperature of the system or things like that.
How?
Using this IPMI, like there is a particular port to which we can interact using IPMI, a dedicated
port. I'm confused. My laptop.
Yes.
Okay, it is switched off. How will you know what is temperature?
IPMI needs special hardware.
The Intel server which we were provided, it has the IPMI built in, IPMI hardware. It's BMC chip
is a special kind of chip. We need that chip to implement IPMI, and that is present in servers. So it's specifically for servers.
So in this, okay, we cannot monitor it via IPMI.
So if this animal has got a BMC chip,
yes.
Okay,
yes,
and the animal is dead.
Yeah.
Okay, you will find its temperature.
Okay, it should be connected. If it's a laptop, so it has a battery. If it's desktop or something like that, it should be connected to the power supply. And then
about that chip, what VMC?
Yes, sir.
If it has got a VMC chip, no?
Let's say the server is down, then we should at least know that the server is down.
That Nagios will tell me. Okay. Just because it cannot monitor a system doesn't mean it will not tell me that there was a system and it has gone off. All network operating systems tell me that,
yes.
Network management systems.
Yes.
Okay, if somebody, they know that earlier there was one animal there, now it is gone. So they will tell me he is dead. Okay, so why do I need this IPMI?
So in case
if Nagios is there.
So all the monitoring services use an application which there are.
Why do I need user terms?
IPMI is needed when we cannot run, like the OS hangs or the system crashes. Then how do
OS hangs, the Nagios tells me that it has hung.
But we can also reboot the system using IPMI. But you cannot do it remotely with any other service. We can reboot the system using the service. That's why I say that we can monitor it below the OS level.
Okay.
So.
Yeah, go ahead. So you are going to allow me to reboot the system is what I have understood. Temperature and all, chhod do. I am not interested.
This is the
log
structure of the IPMI, and so that is the BMC.
What have you done?
Okay, we'll show you the demonstration.
No, in this whole exercise, what have you done?
We have monitored the Intel servers below the OS level. We have added functionality to the Nagios, which helps user monitor the servers more in a user friendly way. And then
there are so many network management software, NSR, so many. So what speciality you have come up with, something which is not previously available with others?
Like the Nagios doesn't have any default IPMI installation or implementation. So we implemented IPMI using Nagios. That was the, and monitored servers at the hardware level.
So you have enhanced Nagios to take care of a unit set of servers which have BMC chip.
Yes,
okay. And only use of your extension is when that idiot is dead.
No,
and
the
only use is when I boot it.
You can monitor it anytime.
No, why should I need it? Nagios will monitor anyway, no?
Not the Nagios? System temperatures or those things.
Huh?
Nagios not those cannot things, monitor like temperature and all the voltage of the system at the...
Give this information about the temperature, voltage,
etc. Oh, so even an alive system you are going to tell me, yes, what is the voltage,
yes,
and what is the,
yes,
temperature.
Sir,
yes,
sir.
That, okay, also needs IPMI.
Only in server farm that is of any
only
use. But I'm still not convinced. Okay? Because server farms have got temperature monitoring systems anyway, which are not in the server, not inside the VMC chip in the server. They're outside. Meaning, I don't understand why you're looking at server card temperature inside my laptop.
Not just temperature, it's also the fan, whether the fan is working or not. It will also go to details of that,
like
also.
All the
fan is working or not, I'm sure that information is available.
All
the information,
okay,
saying,
doesn't matter. So you are attached Nagios. Now show me what you have done.
Server side, if you consider whether it is IBM or HP, PC, they come up with their standard monitoring software which do all such kind of parameters with their server support.
But sir, they are,
but this is open source, general purpose,
yeah,
it's okay add-on. But generally, servers, when you consider, they come up with their own monitoring system.
That's the reason participants is like, we have to make an open source software. This is an education, open source, we have to enhance the ability. Do whatever the proprietary.
Okay, so that's fine. So you tell me what you've done.
So basically,
okay,
we have provided.
Showing me all Nagios. Tumhara kaam kaha hai?
Sir, in the server, Intel server, which you are given, these the IPMI details which is it's showing the IPMI part. This was our work, and when I click the IPMI function, then what we wrote the script. It was just displaying all the details of the IPMI here in a single string which was not readable. All the details which IPMI gives, even if one of them is faulty, then it will just show it that it's critical, and it will not, we were not able to identify which of the parameter it was which is faulty. So what we did was we created another script in PHP. When we click on these IPMI details, it will give all the details of the server segregated. So I can basically see which amongst the critical one and which one is critical and which one is okay, and so we segregated these outputs in a new window and it will monitor.
So we have to study the whole Nagios code in order to identify which file actually
and
gives
also
out.
Basically what Nagios do is you need to, if you have created a plugin, Nagios tell that server to run this plugin, and whatever the plugin is output. What Nagios want, if you have any plugin, he want only four values. These are the minimum, other are the optional. Four values are like 0, 1, 2, 3. If it's return 0, it means it's in OK state. If it returns 1, which means it's a warning. If it's 3, it means unknown, and it's 4, which means critical. So the plugin need to provide that. And also the other information can be provided, but they are the optionals. So you have to create a plugin. What Nagios basically do is, whatever service you have created a plugin, if you want to run that plugin on that server, Nagios will give the instruction to the plugin. Plugin will run on that server, which is basically like Perl or in Python, the script, right? And will whatever the output, it will going to send it back to the Nagios.
So here are all the details which the IPMI was sending.
Okay, you have done this. Okay, is it submitted to Nagios open source community?
We haven't implemented on a large scale, so we haven't.
What do you mean large scale?
Like, we only have implemented,
sir,
on
just monitored 2-3 servers.
Five,
so we are not sure about scalability. Matlab, in the organizations, they monitor.
No,
large
I'm very confused now. From what he told me, okay, your plugin works on the server.
Yes.
So where is the question of scalable? You got 10,000 servers. I got 10,000 plugins working somewhere else. So what scalability are you talking about?
Yeah, but we haven't tested that, or so that's why we haven't put it on their repository
also. But then how do I know?
Where you have tested?
So the servers which we were provided, we have tested locally on
Ek
that.
One server mila unko.
Not three servers, three or four servers.
So it works on power on Ethernet or how?
So it works basically. You are talking that is a separate port. Yeah.
So it is separate from your Ethernet port.
Yeah, it can use the Ethernet port, or if the system is on, then it also can use a separate port. Like
when the system is in a shutdown mode, the NIC is powered up in that state also. So it can use a particular port, which the number of the port is 623, and it can communicate with the NIC.
So we are talking about the hardware rail port. Will you use the Ethernet hardware port or any extra port?
No, Ethernet hardware port.
Ethernet hardware.
Yeah.
So whether it requires the PoE port or non-PoE? PoE stands for power on Ethernet.
Yeah, power on Ethernet. Same
thing. That you require PoE also. If it is a PoE, and in that case, as he has mentioned, that my server is dead, means all the power is being cut down. Still, it will read with the PoE power?
It must be connected to a power source. It may be off.
Connected to the power, but source is down.
No, then it won't be able to monitor. Like if the power source is not there,
PoE will not work?
No. In that case.
But anyway, what I don't understand is, why have you not submitted to Anagios? नहीं नहीं भेजने गए वो तो ओपन सोर्स है
नहीं नहीं भेजेंगे
हाँ भेजेंगे
I think they have already implemented it but in the
हाँ that's exactly what I was going to ask
no sir it's a paid version and their Nagios 11 it's a proprietary software they have implemented it
तो Nagios is not open source
they are two part of Nagios one is Nagios
sir,
core
then Nagios 11
is Nagios HI so what the HI is a proprietary software but Nagios core is a open source software so they have the two parts
So we don't have this.
So if it is not there in this Nagios water open source, why have you not submitted it?
We will submit.
What is stopping you? You are claiming that it is working, no?
Yes, sir.
And then the same thing is told her also. I will not accept it until you give it to open source. If it is open source, either aake mujhe dandora pikta hai, chalta hai, chalta hai, chalta hai, and you are not even confident to. Put your name in the open source community. If it is mud, it is mud. It's for them to decide. I'm not a Nagios expert.
Sir, we can send them a pull request.
Sir, the reason is that Nagios also monitors to cloud's infrastructure as well. So what we haven't tested is on cloud. We are just the direct server. So like how this will going to work on cloud, we have to first test it out and then... We
Why our cloud infrastructure doesn't have your VMC chips? We have got a cloud infrastructure. No? Yes, no. We have cluster at least.
So the server that we have provided, we have tested on it, this is working, that server.
But if you put it in the open source, I will not believe it. So I am not an expert. He is also not an expert.
So we can talk to them.
Talk kya? Write to hota hai udhar. Talk nahi koi bolta hai.
Write to them and request.
You have to submit.
On GitHub it is.
GitHub it is put.
Yes sir, on the FRG.
Put it in there.
Yes sir, we can send them on.
Okay.
Yes, sir. We can send them a pull request.
Yeah. You have to do that.
Yes, sir.
So,
and, sir, some of the features also we have implemented in Nagios. Basically, Nagios was not what we found cumbersome was to add some new host to monitor in the Nagios. Nagios was not providing directly this facility. What we have to do was we have to create the configuration files in by using the terminal and all that stuff we have to do. And in the main config file, we also have to add that file with new file which we are adding to monitor. So what we have provided the GUI for that, we have created the links in the Nagios itself to add a new host, to remove a host, and to add some new service to a particular host. So when we basically these hosts which we are already monitoring.
Whatever you are telling me now, is it there in paid Nagios?
Sir, we don't know.
Sir, so these features are not there. Adding host and
remove. These are not submitted. I don't know anything about Nagios. That is obvious by now, correct? I don't know what this add new host, whether it is a required good thing or bad thing. I have no idea. I know. So all they have put is a nice UI, correct?
Yeah.
Well, it was very cumbersome. So I have
files.
So
file structure and
sir,
make
few
changes in the
It may be there, but what I'm saying is again, if they have done something, why they are not publishing it? Dr. Fatak wants Indian publishing, and why you are shying away from that?
So it's on there on the FRG GitHub. We can send them a pull request if they are.
Pull it? Why? You push it. Pull it. Nobody is going to pull anything from you.
We can send them a push request.
Okay, before you go push.
Yes, sir.
sub whatever is done. Anything else you want to tell me?
Sir, just we want to show you how to add a host and...
I don't want to see how. Why should I see?
That's enough. If you have ideas.
Let the Nagios community see, na? And let them comment that it is Indian code is horrible. Let them say Indian coding standards is horrible. I mean, their part of your work is to be able to write publishable code. My team has not done it. That's okay, but they are not publishing code. Okay. Huh. They are going to that Qvent is going to be open source. They are going to do it. Okay. I don't spend time and effort because I don't use Nagios and Fagios and all that. I don't do that. Okay. Yeah.
Thank you.